This is John Cola with GrowingYourGreens.com with the Thanksgiving update. So today is Thanksgiving. I'm here in California, and last night there was a frost. It reached 29 degrees according to the weather.com website. So I was really sad that while I was gone, I lost all my summer crops. So that's a bad thing. Plus, it's a good thing because I get to show you guys what happens when those crops frost. So why are some crops in my garden still standing and others are dried out and not made it? Well, that's for one reason. Basically, some plants have what you could call built-in antifreeze. So depending on where that plant originated at, they're actually used to that, you know, colder weather. Maybe like Eskimos are used to colder weather, and if you live in the tropics, you're always cold when you go anywhere. So the plants that have the antifreeze within them, and it's a natural antifreeze, of course, basically like the cold weather, and in some cases, especially my kales, they actually get sweeter with cold weather. So I really look forward to this time of year when I could have some nice sweet tree collards and kales. They're really delicious. But the sad thing is all the tomatoes and peppers, the okra and the pumpkins and melons and cucumbers, all those guys didn't make it. So we're gonna take you around and we're gonna show you guys what happened in the garden, and I'm gonna have a lot of harvesting to do today to get it all out and start dehydrating it before it goes really bad, all the produce. So the first bit of damage, as you can see here, is the pumpkin bit. So these are the kakai pumpkins with the edible holes. They're just all dried out. I really didn't like the cold weather. I could harvest all the pumpkins now. There's a couple small ones there. Up in the front here, got some pepper plants. We're gonna have to harvest the peppers. Looks like it was a mild frost. It really wasn't too hardcore because then the leaves would have been all like black. Looks like this plant is actually still alive, so if we did want to, we could actually dig this up, put in a pot, clip back all the dead growth, and it would probably stay alive in the winter in the unheated greenhouse here. So you know, every plant I'm going to take on a case-by-case basis depending on the variety. This happens to be a sweet banana, and actually they were quite a good one. I'm going to take a look at the plant. The best plants I'm going to actually pot up, put in the greenhouse, and you will be able to keep them for a little bit. Here's another bell, nice bell pepper. And this plant's still alive. The end tips got a little bit of, frost damage, but we still got peppers and they're not ripening up yet. So this one's probably a really good candidate for real soon to basically just put in a pot, put in the greenhouse, and hopefully they'll ripen up more. This plant, once again, you could see the top leaves were really damaged, so luckily we didn't get too hard of a frost, but then the bottom ones, they still look kind of, good. So here's the runner bean trellis, over the entryway, and basically they got hit pretty hard some areas. The external areas closest to the outside where there wasn't a lot of protection, definitely all this is just all frost burn. All this needs to get clipped back, cut off. Here's a mature pod we could harvest for the seeds for next year. And the roots for this plant should stay alive underground. It makes a nice big tuber thing that's not edible, but you can leave it in the ground. It'll probably come back next year. And that's on one side. And this is a side we had clipped back a lot because there was a lot of, aphids and stuff going on. But then on this side where there's a lot more foliage, the stud's still doing pretty good. So it definitely wasn't a hard frost, so that's really good. Oh, let's go to the front bed. This is kind of sad. So some of these tomato plants, there's some ripe ones on there, but yeah, this one got really frosted bad. Let's see, the Malabar spinach really didn't like it. This is gone now. These leaves are droopy, they've been frosted, and these aren't gonna come back to life. But we do have some seeds, and there's some seeds there. We could go by and harvest all the little seeds. They're the little seed pods right there. Next door we had all my West Indian burr gherkins. That really didn't like the freeze. They're definitely all gone. All these vines now need to get pulled out. And here's some burr gherkins. If we get them in the next day or two. Still hard. It's still gonna be good for eating. I'm probably gonna pick all these tonight and eat them tonight for dinner. One of my favorites. Here's an eggplant here that was here. And you can see by the leaves, all frost damaged. Looks like we could save it. Looks like, it's not that bad. The inner core. And you could check this out. You could really see the frost damage up here at the top. Here's the leaves that are all brown. And if you look really closely at this stem here, the stem is black, which indicates the frost damage. And if we get down further, it's kind of like really black, and then it kind of goes green-black. And if we go down a lot further near the ground, that's when it still is green, and that's actually still alive. So I'd probably go down to a point, if I did want to save this plant, which I don't, I'd probably go down to a point where, you know, it's not damaged, and then cut it, and then actually just transplant it out. And you can do that, you know, to save the plants, although, you know, if you don't bring them inside or someplace warm, next time it gets cold, it definitely won't make it. Let's see, here's another, here's a pepper plant, didn't look like it fared so well in this area. You know, this pepper needs to get harvested, getting kind of soft. Tomato plant, patio tomato, definitely frost damage, all the brown there. Got a couple of tomatoes to harvest and a couple of tomatoes, ooh yeah, this is a translucent tomato. So the translucent tomato has been frosted, then it thawed out and the cell walls are damaged, and that is basically no good anymore. Here was another eggplant, really, really classic frost damage picture. curled up leaves, black stems. But you know what, if we go down to the bottom, this one is actually fairly well damaged. The one that made it actually was in the center of the bed. And let me tell you, you know, the raised beds here help to add a few degrees, you know, to the plants and gives a few extra, you know, degrees of protection. The other thing that could help really well, and it has been happening lately, is if the ground's wet. So if the ground's wet, that'll keep things a bit more, you know, a little bit warmer. Not a lot warmer, but a little bit warmer. Oh, and look, this is my babies right here. These are the tree collards, and when it gets frosted, they turn like purple. And when they turn purple, they turn much sweeter. So I'm really happy for that. Here's probably the saddest bed of my whole yard. This is a tomato bed that had tons of tomatoes. And I could probably still scavenge some here if I get them today or tomorrow and use them really quick. It looks like they have been frosted and then thawed out a little bit. But depending, you know, there's a lot of foliage here. Oh, there's some ones that really got burned. All these tomatoes are basically gone. You can kind of see the droopy leaves. They just don't look like, well, they're alive anymore. But, you know, once again, down below, if we go really below here, the leaves down below are still alive, and we could save these. No, it's black there. Not good. We could continue on down further. Oh, look, this was actually a fairly frost-tolerant plant, a pepper plant. Looks like the tips got burned a little bit, but for the most part, all the rest of the foliage, the leaves, actually are doing fine. Nice, vibrant plant. This, I think this is some kind of hot pepper. It took off and grew like crazy. And look, so just this pepper here did really well, handled the frost, you know, fairly well. Still alive, still vibrant. The one right next to it, just behind it, look at this thing. This thing's just gone. It's just, it's black. The leaves have been basically frosted, and it's done. And I mean, they're planted literally a foot apart, and that's just the difference in varieties. Some varieties are more frost tolerant than others. Oh, and I really got to check my other ones over there. We'll go down there. That's supposed to be my most frost tolerant variety of peppers. That'll be fun to see. Here's some tomatoes. Let's see. I think they're still good. We get them in the next day or two. These are one of my favorite, the yellow cherries. Mmm. I know what I'm eating for dinner. So this bed's going to be all cleared out. And lots more tomatoes since I've been gone. We'll have to sort all these and pick them. But all the tomatoes are gone now. It's past their time. Other bed that was really negatively affected was the pepper bed. And this is a bad thing, but it's also a good thing. So now I'm going to replant this bed in some winter greens. So that's going to be exciting. You can see this bed didn't fare too well. All the leaves kind of just look droopy and not too happy. And all the plants don't look too happy either. So I think most of these plants are probably just going to get pulled. We're going to harvest what we can and pull them all. But it looks really cool. You could just look in there, and I'll give you an overhead shot here. You could see like all the ripe peppers, just all those little red dots. Those are all ripe peppers. So I definitely have a lot of ripe peppers. And whether they're ripe or not, you know, I'm definitely going to dehydrate them, or so I think my friend likes green peppers, so maybe they'll get a big bag. Oh, this will be fun here. Check this out. Oh my gosh. To see how the frost tolerance of the pepino melon, number one. And this is the pepino melon. It took off growing like crazy. It had all these crazy large fruits. And, you know, here's just some of the fruits. And some of the plant that was actually sheltered is still alive. So this is part of the plant that was closer towards the middle and, you know, more protected, where more there's more leaves, it keeps it warmer. And this is more exposed out, you know, without any protection. They didn't make it. But so there's layers of the Pinot that did and did not make it. So out to a certain extent, didn't make it. And if you go in a little bit deeper, they still made it because it wasn't a super hard frost. So I'm grateful for that. And let's check out some of these fruits. They're just not ripening up yet. But oh my God, maybe they are. They're turning colors here. These things are absolutely gigantic. I mean, that's like the size of my hand. We'll have some pepino melons pretty soon. Oh my gosh, this is really sad too. Well, I can still salvage it. This is cool. My Cuban oregano, also maybe called Mexican oregano. Once again, it wasn't a hard frost. If it was, this would have been totally gone. But you could see the end tips are definitely fried, or actually more appropriately frosted. But if we go down, there's the plant's still alive. So these ones, you could actually take cuttings and root the cuttings. Actually, no rooting hormone is required, so you could do that. And the other thing is the plant is still alive, so we're going to basically cut back all the bad parts of the plant that aren't alive, and then pull up the whole root ball and replant it. So I did have two varieties in here. I had a variegated variety here, and also I had a green variety. So I'm trying to find the green variety because it was alive. Here's the green variety if we follow it back maybe. No, this is the variegated. But anyways, between the green and the variegated, looks like the variegated, I think this was the green. But the variegated variety looks actually to be a little bit more frost tolerant than the total green variety. On to the poha berry plant. Here's the poha berry, or also called Cape Gooseberry or Incan berry. Let's see, that got fairly frosted, you can see by the leaves there. And the other one that I was really curious about and how it was going to do with the frost, and actually it's holding up pretty good. I don't see any damage actually, so this is really exciting for me. This is the leaves for the lychee tomato, Morel de Babis. Totally, you can see the damage on the pepino melon here, right next door, got the same amount of frost. And these are still going strong. Looks like the flowers actually are quite sensitive. Some of the flowers didn't look like they liked the frost too much. But all the leaves pretty much look like they're unaffected. Yeah, definitely the flowers didn't make it, but the leaves are fine so far. So I might take some cuttings of those as well and root those. They should root actually fairly well. So that's really exciting.
So it's getting dark and I wanted to film this last clip before it got too dark to film. I've been working diligently in this bed. That bed had, I don't know, one pepper plant every basically 1 square foot. It's the end of the season. I've harvested a lot of peppers off it this year. But I want to give you the update on what I just harvested because it did frost, soft frost last night. A lot of the plants didn't make it. And, you know, there's some that I saved at the end here that were actually protected by a mallow that was a weed, actually, but that I was also eating. So I'm going to transplant some of those into pots and put them in the greenhouse. But I've yielded a lot of ripe peppers. So here's one box here, and this is basically 10 pounds of ripe peppers that I just harvested. And these are the ones for me. I like to eat only the ripe peppers, they're the best. And then over on this side here, I got a big tote here. And this tote has all the unripe peppers, so all the greens. And you know, 95% of these are all right. This one's a little bit soft because it did get frozen, a little bit too frozen. So you could use this in the next, like tonight or tomorrow. Or otherwise it's got to get chucked. But the rest of these are nice and firm, and they will last in the fridge. I have a friend that likes to juice the green peppers and eat them. So these are going to go to my friend here, and I'm going to use the ripe one. So 30 pounds of peppers, end of season harvest, and I'm sure I've harvested at least that much all during the season. I've really enjoyed growing a variety of peppers this year. I think I grew over, I don't know, 20 varieties or something crazy. And I really enjoy the small peppers. And once again, if you are going to grow peppers, I encourage you to grow the small peppers. My favorite pepper this year was that peppercini pepper for eating. But I really like the cherry bomb pepper. They are the absolute number one in yield. They produce a lot of fruits early and then even continued late. Actually, there's a cherry bomb over there that's still alive that I'm going to transplant and try to keep alive in the greenhouse. So also grow the mini bell peppers. The smaller the pepper, generally the more fruits they produce. Otherwise, you know, you could plant like one plant of like the big bells and they might have like one bell pepper on it or one pepper on it. So if you want a lot of, I'd rather have a lot of little fruit than like one or two big fruits. So plant the small ones. So once again, this is John Kohler with growingyourgreens.com. Got to get back to harvesting some peppers. We'll see you next time and keep growing those fresh fruits and vegetables and eating them too. We'll see you next time.